Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in Goldcrest Valley and I'm just kind of peeking in at the greenhouse over here. And let me get that speed back down. There we go. 5 in the morning, chickens should be waking up soon and we've got a nice crop of tomatoes in there. Now for some reason I planted trees. Don't know why I did that. Poplars. Those are the poplar trees, aren't they? Anyway, let's go collect the eggs and get this day going. Make sure not to step on any of these. Alright, that's where I get everybody dizzy trying to find all of the eggs. I keep forgetting to go and sell these things. They're going to be rotten in my backpack soon. Anything over there? Nope, there's one. Excuse me. Anything in there? No. That looks shallower than that. Maybe this goes in deeper. I notice those things. Alright. Are we good? I think we are. Mr. Rooster. I haven't heard you crow yet. Thank you. He times that really well each time. So, what to do today? We've got a day, or a phase? I don't know what you call each of these. We got a growth cycle. Soil, growth, doesn't really give me a clue. Anyway, we should be needing a fertilizing on these, except we did set it to for a one-time fertilizing now instead of three stages. So, we've got fertilizing at dark blue. So full fertilizing are on these fields now. And that's good. We don't need to keep doing that. We've seen it enough times now. Back. So don't have to deal with that. We do have field number 12 over here that is plowed. It needs to be cultivated. And then it needs to be planted and fertilized. So let's grab this guy and grab the bigger cultivator. One that requires this tractor to run. Then I'm thinking of heading over and putting the hay bales over into the sheep shed, which is always entertaining to watch. Not so entertaining to perform, but here we go. Let's see, unfold that. And I know how straight I can plow and cultivate things, so I think I will be hiring this one out. Right from the beginning. There we go. 6 miles an hour. To me, it looks like this tractor wheels are slipping a little. They're 7 miles an hour. Going downhill. Be curious to see what he does uphill. Let's bail out of here. And we'll use the Manitou to put the hay bales in place over there. I think the New Holland would do just fine with a little sower. I'd love to use the bigger sower on that, but I need 2 bigger tractors to do that. And that's not until we infuse some extra funds into the system. Then we get to use the bigger equipment all the time. But we're still using the little stuff. Let's try that one. There we go. One more. There. Whoa. Now, we are full, so we can take this right in there. Seems like this guy runs at 6 miles an hour. He was doing 5 to 7 going down there. Don't know if I dare turn him on yet. I think I want a few passes in between. We'll get him into place. Now, before I started this one, I went back over to the cow farm. Try and figure out why that one implement wouldn't work. The one to clean the cattle feed area. So I brought the bucket with me to clean it all up. Went to dump it in and it wouldn't accept it. And I realized it's full. So it wouldn't work because there was no more room to accept it. So that experiment may not have failed as badly as I thought. So we'll have to wait till they've eaten down the supplies a bit. And then we'll be able to test it for real. Is he going to get past me? I wonder how quickly he makes his starts his turn. I'll pull forward a little bit. Let's jump in, though, and see what speed he's driving at. 4 miles an hour. We're doing some slipping. I'm pretty sure that's what's going on. 4 and 5, 3. Yeah, we're slipping here. We're not... This really takes quite a bit of horsepower to pull. I've got wheel weights on there, but apparently it's not enough. I wonder. Let's unhire you. Q. Yeah, grab a weight and put it on the front. I don't know that that would make a difference, but I want to find out. Wow, the fog is rolling in. I have a hazy morning. It says it's cloudy out. Doesn't look cloudy to me. There's the roof. Let's get the big one. Alright, let's find out if this makes a difference. And how do I do that without having to wait for a whole other cycle? Let's take him back through. Let him redo that last little bit. And I need to have the hired hand redo it. They travel at different speeds. Is there a chance I can just go straight back? I mean, theoretically, yes. Alright, so what happens? Well, let's go a little further, because you're going to be slowing down to hit the end. Alright, hire you. And 5 and 4. Yeah, you're freaking out because you're saying this is already done. Okay. That's not going to help. Though I could run you back to the bottom. That would do it. Let's do that. Wonder why he would run the flashers inside the field. The hired hands. Just realized that they're running right now. Alright, something like that. Now, we're pretty flat here. It builds elevation over there. So 7 miles an hour. We'll just drive him for a while. So, sheep are overfed and cattle are overfed. So that cleanup device would not have worked at either one. So I'll have to wait on that. But this is still version 1.3.1. Here in the next few days, we should switch over to 1.4. And I'm curious to see what changes happened in the game with that. I don't expect much. It's mostly, from what I gathered, more of a console change. Or enabling more things so the consoles have access to more of what the PC already has. So I don't think it's going to change a lot in game here. But I think we're kind of done. I'm looking at 5 miles an hour there, 6. Kind of done with what we're doing here. We've run these fields several times. We've used all the equipment over and over. And it takes so long. I'm not hitting that 3 and 4 anymore. So 5 and 6. Okay. That's kind of what I wanted to know. Let's dive off here. I think it is time to insert some extra funds. And get the bigger equipment. Get some bigger fields. Start doing, you know, different things. Otherwise, it's me for hours off-screen contracting jobs until I'm tired of playing the game. I don't want to get there. I want to keep it fun and fresh. So fire this guy up, hire him out for canola, and go. All right, these guys are done. Try to get back in time to get the cultivator out of there so the sower can finish. But what's next? I think next is the Manitou. And drive this back over to the sheep area. and load up that one spot, that one stack. Let's peek here, though. 90%. Ooh, good. So probably get some of this in this episode, too. Let's spin around here and hit that button. And quite foggy. So let's get some lights as well. I don't have hazards. I do have a hazard. And I've got a really sharp pokey thing up here, too. So let's do this for traveling. All right. Boy, it really is foggy out here. 6 in the morning. Morning haze rolls in. Pretty realistic. I've seen that many times. Oh. Yeah, he's still on the trailer. Kind of forgot that part. Okay. Well, I guess we have no choice but to use our magic teleportation device and grab the other case. Not that one. Let's grab this one. There we go. So, yep, I think so. Alright, I'm guessing by 7 in the morning this will all burn off. Nice and clear again. Let's get this guy hooked up. Where do we put these? Not only that, really need 4 bales. Am I there? Yeah. So I need to easily pick up the other 4. Let's do this. We'll back it all in. I think I left the lights on the Manitou. Yep. I always carry a portable battery charger with me. Because I run batteries down on these farm vehicles quickly and often. Alright, let's pop him right there. You got room? We got room. Hello. Y breaks it loose. Almost loses it. And why close it back down? I am amazed that doesn't knock it over. Whew. All right, pull this guy in. There he goes. Quite a delay in that one. And let's get this off to the side. Over here is fine. Yeah. Lights. And we're out of here. Yep, left all the lights on. Okay, turn that off. And yeah, we'll put them both on. It's kind of hard to see everything right now. Now, the chance of grabbing the top two without pushing the pile over. I need to get it quite high. Let's see, that's that one. Yeah, about like that. Alright. See if that's enough. Centered? I'm centered. Can't tell from here. Nice and slow. There we go. So, let's lift, pivot. There we are. Oh. I need the end. That's right. Well, let's do it this way then. A little trick I learned last time. Alright. Let's bring it down. I see. I'm in the hay bales. And if I, as I pivot, will they fall off the spikes? They will. Okay. That works. Back out. Pivot back. Whoa. Right there. Down. Do it again. Boy. Almost like I've had practice. First, I've got to get it inside here. Let's do that one. Okay. That'll help. A little further forward. And swing it in. Clear the corner. Okay. Something like that. Now, let's get you guys level. You up a little higher. Gotta miss that bale right there. Boom. Over there. Back off a little. Okay. Down. Pivot downward just slightly. And is that enough? It is enough for one. Okay. Zoom in here a little closer. Alright. Press down a little harder on the back end. That did it. Okay. And they rolled right into place. Good job. Where's the back end of this? Here we are. And that's kind of how it's done. Right there. All right, height here. Just wondering if I could come in from the top to begin with. Let's see here. Down, straight. Let's see. Something like that. Might be able to. I'm hitting there, though. I need to grab as low as I can, because I've got to not hit the ceiling in there. About like that. So I've got to back up as I go down, because it's going to be hitting at a diagonal. No, got to go down first, though. Okay, I'm in. Just like surgery. Now, what do you want to bet? When I lift up a little and flip it forward, they land in the river. Okay, it's up. And pivot. Oh, this could go so bad. Urgh, gotcha. Roll back. Bring that in. Bang it. There we are. Whew. Back down. And let's go put them away. And don't drive over the trough over there. It tends to make bales disappear. That'd be fun to do in real life. Actually sitting in there performing surgery on the hay bales like that. Okay, up a little. Got the roof to worry about, though. Okay, looking good there. Am I there? I think I'm there. Okay. Down. I'm off centered a little bit, though. Alright, something like... Ooh. Okay, I thought I just kicked the bottom out over there. Okay, so you... We want to pivot like that. Up a little. Okay, can I back out? Yeah. Yeah, that bottom one wants to roll so bad. Now, if we really wanted to, we could fill the entire back end. I don't really want to. Okay. Actually, that's right. We can park this in here because we have the other tractor here. So let's do that. And back it up. Like so. Alright, lights. Okay, let's get these guys back onto a trailer. Thought I was going forward. A surprising moment when you thought you were going forward and you end up crashing back into a tree. Yeah, probably should have not put the... Alright, you go back up. I have got to do some turning around here. We're going to destroy those bushes. Let's see if it's possible. It looks like it is. Get enough room in here to do this. There we go. Can we unwind that? Kind of. Okay. I think that's enough. All right. B. Bird's eye view. All right. Where do these go? Well, we know we're going to make 100 more of them. We just take them and sell them. Yeah, I think so. We'll sell these and park the trailer, and then what? Then I want to test the price of a silage bale versus a silage bucket. Still want to know which is worth more, loose silage or baled rolled silage. So let's get this sold and figure out how to do that. I think I need the bucket on the tractor over at the cattle area. Unfortunately, I can't sell anything over there, so I have to drive that all the way over to the other silage pit. Sell over there. Anyway, we do have a cultivator to get off that field, so we gotta get that one done too. This just looks like the fastest way. Now I can see what I'm doing. And that's right, I can't just drive this through and sell it. I've got to actually take it off the trailer. Which means I've got to back it up. I've got it floored, that's why it's reacting a lot quicker than I usually see it. Alright, right there. Alright, so the silage grass bales, or hay bales, were worth 1,400 and something each. These guys, now straw bales are worth 300 and something each. So let's see what this one's worth. 288, even less than straw. So I'm pretty sure straw was 350 something. So, why? And that will pull in on its own. Let's go get this guy parked. Bunker silo is done fermenting. Which one? Which one is considered bunker? Or is that just the official name of the of those silos? I want right there. Made it. Alright, something like that. And we're 7 in the morning, still quite foggy out. Okay, so let's go find the cultivator, see where he's at. How far? Otherwise, I guess we will, go to one or the other. And we've got the Manitou's bucket over at the sheep, but that's a huge bucket. So I'm pretty sure it's going to be, you're over there. Let's find out. All right. Where do we start? Front loaders. Little bucket is only 1,800. Okay. Then what is the telehandler? Is that what I'm looking for? There we go. And telehandler parts, I think, are in the same category. Right there. You are 4,500. All right, that's close enough to where we can make a fair estimate. So, need to get this guy back over to the cattle area, grab the bucket. Hope I'm remembering that right. Map. Or is that bucket here somewhere? If it's over here, Should be able to click around and see all the implements that are there. Not getting the sense it's there. Okay. He's got about two more passes to go. Let's drive around here. Bunker silo was done fermenting. Well, one or the other, they're both done now. Now, did I leave that in here? Wait a minute, what are you? You're the big one. No, you're the roller. This fog is kind of hard to see. It's over with the sheep, isn't it? I think it is. Let's just park this guy. Don't really need any other attachments at the moment. Lights, and jump over to... Wait a minute, back up one. That was it, right? That didn't do it. Shift. There we go. There you are. And there's the bucket. Okay, that's what I needed to know. So, fire you up, drive you out of there. And let's get you leveled off. Like that. And where? Let's actually go into here. Something like that. Correct one? Yes, there's only one of this one. Okay. So let's take this guy over to the biogas plant. Though I still... Okay, so we'll wait till the message comes up that the cultivator's finished. I saw what was going on. He's twice as far as the other one. So there's plenty of time. In fact, actually, there is plenty of time. I'm going the wrong way. I am. Got to jump a railroad track over here. We're going that way. But there should be time to put a scoop in and get back if we need to move the cultivator so the sower can finish. And also, before I forget, because I did forget, plant growth slow. There we go. Yeah. I don't want a field transition. Boy, it might have. That's full growth there. Let me look at this. Over here, map and the growth stages. Cultivated, sown, plowed. So we're still in the same stage of growth here. I don't want, you know, light yellow and light green in the same field. We ran into that problem here, I think, at the very beginning of the game. Okay, so hopefully slowing the growth down is going to allow the rest of the planting to get done in time. But let's head over to the biogas plant and uncover that thing. Look at the silage and then sell a bucket. Now, we want 4,000. So we should be able to scoop until it says really close to 4,000. Should be able to monitor it that way and or meter it that way. Do that. And we'll put our itty-bitty little flash beacon on. Just for fun. Oh. Okay, wasn't expecting that one. So I guess we don't have to worry about him running into the back of the other one. Okay, so let's... Can I do that from the cab is what I'm curious about. Anything going to show up here? Silage 100%, but no way to interact with it. Okay. You out. There we are. Open silo. R. Oh, do we open it in stages? Maybe as I use it, it goes away. Okay. Alright. Something like that. Let's see if we can gauge 4,000 into this. Yeah, as I get closer... Oh, I see. I'm going up in the air. I'm riding it like a ramp. Okay. So let's head back down. I gotta be careful. It'll spill out on the ground on me. There we go. Alright. That's really close. That's way too much. Okay. So up. And dump. Trying to stop at 4. Close enough. See if I can touch it one more. Okay. Woohoo! Because I'm just that good. Okay. Let's do this. Whoa! But let's not do it that fast. This is a zippy little vehicle. It's dangerous. Okay, so we're looking for 1450 something. That's what the bail was worth. Alright, that's far enough there. There we go. Okay, we're emptied. 1695. Okay, well, there's the answer. It's easier to make it this way than wrapping all those individual bales, and it's more profitable. Okay, let's kill the lights, and let's go fix what's going on over here. And you are done. Okay. So he can only get barely over halfway with this sower. And it's still foggy out. So 8 a.m. must be the fog trigger. Plenty of fertilizer left. Right there. Yeah. You'll see the seed bin filling up there. Perfect. Boy, you get up here, you can't see it all. There I am. Where am I? Boy. Quite delayed when you're down there. Something like that. Well, let's hire it out. If I don't like it, then I'll kick him in a little bit. I can't tell. I'm trying to go out faster than he's going. It looks pretty good. I think he lined it up well. Okay. So you're going to continue there. Yeah, that line's in the fog, but it looks pretty straight. Consistent with the rest of it. Okay, jump out of view. Let's get this guy put away. All the lights are off this time. That's interesting. Sometimes they turn them off and sometimes they don't. Oh, they're running without lights because it's after 7 a.m. Okay, pulled you up. You're in the air? You are. Let's get... Oh, they took the sign out. Let's get this guy cleaned up, and we'll head back over to the biogas plant and put a few more scoops into there. And then I want to... Great demand for sugar beets! Oh, we just had our plans changed. Let's get this cleaned up, and we'll take a look and see what that means. Alright, what do I want here? Let's kill the engine noise. Jump over that. There we go. I was going to go and make some more total mixed rations with the bucket over there just to see how that works without using a bale. I think instead we're going to go haul some sugar beets. Because we just happen to have some. This guy could use a little bath too. Alright. Put him away and grab both tippers. First of all, though, where are we going? What is the great sale? Or great demand? Let's see. Prices are over here. Also, I was noticing between episodes, the case that is in the worst shape is still in that $1,000 a day range. So 1,037. Let's try to remember that and see what it is the next day. See, to, you know, to what extent that goes up. I don't know what the ceiling is on these. Back to prices. Sugar beets are these guys. Great demand of 219. Maple Field Mill. That's by the sheep, right? No names. No, it's not. We're clear over here. Oh, the train. Oh, the train. Huh. Is my timer correct? Am I really 38 minutes into this? Actually, it is. I'll tell you what. Let's pull out of this. I'm going to stop recording here so we can take all of next episode to load up the train with all of the sugar beets. Bring an entire train load over there and dump it all at once. That sounds like fun. The fog is clearing. I think we have a plan. Let's call it done right here, and I'll catch you next time, folks. Thanks. Bye-bye.